गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर ज्ञान ज्योति ऑनलाइन क्लास। सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट और यू कैन से डिस्कस अबाउट द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर ऑफ आवर जियोग्राफी सेक्शन, जियोग्राफी सब्जेक्ट। एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज व्हाट? मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज। व्हाट? मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री। ओके, सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक्स लाइक व्हाट इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग वॉर, और यू कैन से व्हाट इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री। ओके, आफ्टर दैट इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री। ओके, आफ्टर दैट एग्रीकल्चर एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री, हाउ दिस टू सेक्टर्स आर इंटर रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर। ओके, आफ्टर दैट सम इम्पोर्टेंट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज लाइक कॉटन टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्रीज, जूट इंडस्ट्रीज। ओके, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इन दिस चैप्टर। गॉट इट? After that, the classification of manufacturing industries mean what type of category the manufacturing industries are divided. Okay, we will learn about in this chapter. So this type of topics are combined to, so you can say, chapter manufacturing industry. Got it? So let's start the chapter from what is manufacturing. Industry means simply it is indicate to industries where the finished goods are produced. Okay, that are called industries, or in simple word you can say or factories. But what is manufacturing? Okay, I'm right here that production of goods after processing from raw materials, okay, to more valuable products is called manufacturing. So best example of raw material, okay, like cotton. Okay, in factories, what cotton was processing through a mechanical process, after that what the finished good like cloth we get. Got it? From nylon, you can say from cotton cloth also we get from raw material like cotton. We receive what? Cotton products or cotton clothes. That clothes are the finished goods. Got it? So what is manufacturing? Production of goods after processing through it, you can say mechanical process or chemical process from raw materials to more valuable product. After what? If raw material after processing, the value of, or you can say the economic value or price of raw material what going up after it come to what? Finished goods. Got it? More valuable product is called manufacturing. Got it? After that, it is in the group of secondary sector. Okay, in our previous, you can say in our previous chapters, we had discussed about what the sectors of Indian economy, that there are three types of what economy sector. One, primary sector, the agriculture what based on primary sector. After that, secondary sector is also known as manufacturing in the sector. After that, tertiary sector, which is usually known as the service sector. Okay, so the manufacturing industry, or you can say the manufacturing sector, is in the group of secondary sector. Okay, and it is an important economic source for the development of a country, because every sectors of Indian economy, what primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector, these are interrelated to each other. As you can say, these are interdependent to each other. That's why these industries are, you can say, play a key role for the development, for the economic development of a country. Got it? After that, the importance of manufacturing industry. What are the importance of manufacturing industries? Importance of manufacturing industry. as we have already known that the agriculture is the backbone of our economic sector. Okay, so you can say also the manufacturing sector, the manufacturing sector, or you can say the manufacturing industry also helps in growth of agriculture sector. Okay, and is also reduce the burden of unemployment over agricultural sector. So generally you can say what in the economic development, what manufacturing industries played an important role in the what national economy. Got it? So this is the first importance of manufacturing industry, that the manufacturing industries, or you can say through the manufacturing industries, agricultural sector or the primary sector is also developed. Why? Because in manufacturing industries, it modernizing what the agricultural tools, what modernizing agricultural tools means the machinery, equipments. Okay, these equipments are made in manufacturing industry. That's why what the agricultural work, or you can say the farming activities, are you can say developed day by day. Okay, with the help of what? Manufacturing industries. Okay, after that what it reduces the you can say unemployment or employment burden over agriculture. Okay, nowadays what most of the person, they are involved in manufacturing sector, or they are an employee in manufacturing sector. Okay, but in the far beginning, okay, the people, mostly the people of India, they were involved in only on agricultural work. But after the setup of secondary sector and manufacturing industries, okay, many people are also what involved or take employment in manufacturing industry. So it reduces the unemployment burden in agriculture. Okay, what it reduces the unemployment burden over agriculture. After that, it creates what? More employment. Okay, so nowadays what many people, or most of the people, they are involved in manufacturing industries and gain economic facility, or you can say economic benefit from manufacturing industry, as you can say also from secondary sector. Okay, after that it helps exports of manufactured goods brings foreign exchange, means the finished goods what we are exported to the abroad to foreign nations. Okay, what it brings foreign exchange or foreign relation between two country. Got it? Means through the import and export, through the transportations, okay, a country can able to make a good relationship or business relationship with another country. Okay, by the manufacturing industry, what we are exporting the finished good to another country and maintain good business relationship with each other. Got it? After that, it helps in transforming raw materials into a wide variety of furnished goods of higher value. Yeah, this is true, that raw material after processing, mechanical processing, or through a you can say chemical processing, okay, the value of that raw material grows high. Okay, after it may make into what finished goods like cotton. Okay, if cotton is a raw material, you can see in form of raw material, then the value of cotton is lower than the value of cotton cloth has, just like that. Okay, so this is the importance, or these are the importance of manufacturing sector or manufacturing industries in our national economy. Got it? After that, how agricultural sector or the primary sector and industrial sector is interrelated to each other, means agriculture and industries. So agriculture and industries are dependent on each other. Industries gives a major boost to agriculture by rising its productivity by providing their tools and products such as fertilizers, etc. Yes, what the manufacturing industries always try to modernizing the agricultural tools or farming tools, and also provided the agricultural sector develop fertilizers for develop in food grains. So generally, or you can say, yeah, this is true that the economic agriculture sector and manufacturing industry sector, or primary sector and secondary sector, or you can say also tertiary sector also involved in, they are dependent on each other. Okay, then industry depends on agriculture for raw materials. Industries, manufacturing industries depends upon agriculture for raw material. Okay, and agriculture depends on manufacturing industries for machinery equipments, for what? Modern tools and fertilizers. Got it? Then, and sell their products such as irrigation pumps, fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides, plastic and PVC pipes, machines and tools, etc. to the farmers. Got it? After that, the contribution of industry to national economy. Contribution of industries, or you can say manufacturing industries in national economy. How the manufacturing industries, what play it roles for the development of economic sector of our country. The contribution of industry in the GDP. GDP means what? Gross domestic product is very low in India as compared to East Asian economies. The National Manufacturing Competitiveness Council, NMCC, has been set up by the government to take appropriate policy measures to improve the productivity of manufacturing sector. Okay. As compared to other Asian country, okay, the manufacturing, or you can say the condition of manufacturing industry is very low in India. That's why the national, you can say the national NMCC, the National Manufacturing Competitiveness Councils, always try to make policy for the development of manufacturing industries in India. Okay, then it also comprise of some factors like where the industries are located. Okay, means the industrial location. Industrial location are influenced by the availability of raw material, labor, capital, power and market. Yes, it is also one of the, you can say, important factor for growth of manufacturing industries in India. What? The industrial location. Okay, you can say it depends upon the locations. Okay, that the labor are work there or not. Okay, or raw material, the manufacturing industries can able to found raw material or not. After that, the capital means expenditures. Okay, if the location is appropriate for manufacturing industries, then it will be beneficial for national economy. So what, industrial location is one of the important factors for growth of manufacturing industries, or you can say development of manufacturing industries in every country. Okay, after on industrial activity starts, urbanization follows. Urbanization means what? Townships.
surrounding the manufacturing industries. There what the townships is also raised up. Okay, then cities provide markets and also provide services such as banking, insurance, transport, labor, consultants and financial advice etc. to the industries. So it is one of the what important factor that the location of industrial sector is one of the important source, you can say source or factors responsible for economic growth of a nation. If the location is correct or the if the location is suitable, then the cities also surrounding surrounding the industries, the cities also grows up, and after the cities grows up, many type of you can say national facilities like banking, then consultants, okay, and the people also migrate from rural areas to township area for work there, and it what grows up the national economy. Okay, after that many industries tend to come together to make use of the advantages offered by the urban centers known as what agglomeration economies. Got it? So the industrial location is also you can say the important factor for growth of national economy. Okay, after that the classification of industries. So now the topic is what the classification of manufacturing industries. Okay, so you can say the class of manufacturing industries are different types, or you can say there are different types of industries present in India, in every country. Okay, the first one is on the basis of source of raw material. Okay, the manufacturing industries are divided into two categories: agro-based industries and mineral-based industries. Got it? Then on the basis of capital investment, it is small scale industries and large scale industries, where what small amount of currency or small amount of you can say money invest, that industry is known as small scale industries, and you can say the company, the industries which contain very large amount of money, that industries is known as what large scale industries. That on the basis of ownership, industries are also classified into three groups: private sector industries, public sector industries and joint sector industries. After fourth one is based on the weight of raw material, what it is heavy industries and light industries. Okay, this is the general classification of what manufacturing industries. So first, agro-based industry. Okay, let's have discuss about what agro-based industries. Agricultural product like cotton, jute, silk, woolen, textile, sugar, edible, etc. Okay, on the industries which are based on agricultural raw material, or which industries depend on agricultural raw material for finished their good or finished for producing finished good, that industries are known as agro-based industries. Okay, later on we will discuss about some of the important agro-based industries in India, like cotton industries, jute industries. After that, mineral based industries like iron industries. Okay, after the different type of manufacturing industries like chemical industries, we will discuss about in this chapter. Okay, so first thing is what the industries which are depends upon agricultural raw material like cotton, silk, woolen, jute. Okay, that industries are known as agro based industries. After that, the industries which are based on minerals like what iron, steel, manganese. Okay, that type of industries are known as what mineral based industries. Got it? So
let's discuss about what some of the important agriculture yeah, agro based industries in our country. That the first one is textile industry. So textile industries, it contribute 4% towards our GDP, gross domestic product. Means it give to national economic about approximately 4% in GDP. It is the only industries in the country which is self reliant and complete in the value chain from raw material to the highest value added product. Then it is the second largest employment generating sector in India after agriculture. So textile industries were give the opportunity to the young masses, or you can say to the people of every country. Mostly we are discussing about our country, that's why people of India mostly it provided employment facilities to what most of the population of India. What after that, the cotton textile industries. India producing cotton textiles since ancient times, since from old period, with hand spinning and handloom weaving techniques. After the 18th century, power looms came into use and traditional industries suffer a setback. The first successful textile mill was established in Mumbai in 1854. In the year of 1854, okay. The first cotton industries was set up in Mumbai. Then in the early years, the cotton textile industries were concentrated in the cotton growing belt of Maharashtra and Gujarat. This was the due to availability of raw cotton market, transport including accessible port facilities, labor, moist climates, etc. Okay, in the beginning, this type of facilities were provided, mostly provided in Maharashtra and Gujarat. That's why in the beginning period, okay, manufacturing industries were set up in Maharashtra and Gujarat. Okay, because the transportation means the sea route is also there. That's why what the cotton, mostly the cotton industries were what established there. Then spinning continues to be centralized in Maharashtra, Gujarat and Tamil Nadu. However, weaving is highly decentralized to provide scope for incorporating traditional skills and designs of weaving in cotton, silk, zari, embroidery, etc. India has world-class production in spinning from ancient time. Okay, from beginning period, what we were exported what cotton clothes, okay, silk clothes, silk material to what foreign country from old period. So India is the famous, you can say, cotton import country. Cotton or you can say cotton raw material based product to the other nations, export to the other nation. Then after that, India is the second largest installed capacity of spinless tool used in spinning in the world after China. Yeah, India have last year in the world trade of cotton about 1/4 of the total trade. However, our trade in garments is only 4% of the world's total, but in the cotton field we are the second largest country in the world. Okay, after that, what type of problems what that cotton textile industry facing nowadays? It is you can say it is an agro based industries, and some obstacles are also there. Some obstacles are also faced by what cotton industries, okay, which is a, you can say, headache for our national economy. Okay, so let's have discussed some problems which are faced by cotton industries in our country. The first point is irregular supply of electricity. Okay, then old and outdated machinery.
then low output of labor and though competition with the synthetic fiber industry. Okay, so these are the important problems faced by cotton industries, or you can say these are the factors which are stopped to grow cotton industry rapidly in our country. Okay, these are the obstacles for the development of cotton industries in our country. What? The irregular supply of electricity, then after the lack of labor, then old and outdated machinery equipments or tools also, to competition with the synthetic fiber industry. So these are the problem. Okay, after that the jute textile, or you can say jute industries. India is the largest producer of raw jute and jute goods. Most of the jute mills in India are located in West Bengal, mainly along the banks of the Hooghly River. The first jute mill was set up near Kolkata in 1859 at Risram. So the first jute mill was established in Kolkata in the year of 1859. Remember this thing, okay? The factor responsible for their location in the Hooghly Basin are presence of jute producing areas, okay? Most of the means riverside areas, the people who are living in riverside areas, they are mostly what produced goods like raw material like jute. Okay, then inexpensive water transport, mean it is easy for them to get what water facilities or irrigation facilities because they are live in what river valley area, riverside area. Okay, that's why the irrigation facility easily available by the people. Okay, then supported by a good network of railways, roadways and waterways to facilitate movement of raw material to the mills. Okay, then you can say there are transport facilities also, like waterways, after that roadways and railways. These three type of you can say transport facilities were there. That's why many of jute industries are established in what inside of Hooghly River or Hooghly Basin. Then abundant water for processing raw jute, then cheap labor from West Bengal and adjoining states of Bihar, Orissa and Uttar Pradesh, means cheap labor facilities were also there. Means the industrial owner, okay, you can say they were able to what avail the labor in a low wages, in a low salary. Then Kolkata as a large urban center from ancient time provides banking, insurance and port facilities for export of jute goods. Okay, so from the beginning what the many jute industries, many you can say many company owner, okay, they were established the jute industry, jute textile the side of Hooghly Basin, because they were easily available what the labor facilities there, after that the transportation facilities were also there. Nowadays is also what the jute industries, most of the jute industries are located in Calcutta, okay, because the facilities are easily available there. After that, what type of challenges? Yes, like what the problem faced by cotton industry, so challenges are for jute industries also, like the steep competition in the international market from synthetic substitutes and from the competitors like Bangladesh, Brazil, Philippines, Egypt and Thailand. Meant in jute industries there you can say there is a great competition between the nations. So that's why yes, jute industries also has you can say old machinery equipment, okay, it face also the lack of electricity. That's why what we are unable to participate in the race, because many other countries are also what modernizing their jute industries. Got it? After that, National Jute Policy was passed in 2005. Okay? With the objective or with the aim of increasing productivity, improving quality, ensuring good prices to the jute farmers and enhancing the yield per hectare. Okay? For the upliftment, or you can say for the enhancement, for the development of jute industries, a committee, okay, or a policy was formulated or executed in the year of 2005 for the development of what, jute industry. So this is all about today's class. Okay, in our next class we will discuss about the rest of the important topics in our books. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.